Hello and welcome to the Circuit Paul Ricard, current home of the French Grand Prix, an event dating all the way back to 1906. It's been held at many venues over the years, with famous moments from Dijon and Manicourt the feature of many a highlights reel. And let's hope we see more of those in the race today. The Circuit Paul Ricard then, a 3.6-mile track, 25 miles east of Marseille. 15 corners here, 6 to the left and 9 to the right, with the main overtaking chance expected going into turn 8. Top speeds today should be around 205 miles per hour. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat, Anthony Davidson. And our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching for as they go down into turn 1?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn 1 as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Joker, Charles Leclerc and Sainz, Norris, Ricciardo, Raikkonen and Pierre Gasly, Stroll, Tsunoda, Esteban Ocon and Giovinazzi, Russell, Eilert, Mick Schumacher and Nicholas Latifi. Mazepin and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Thank you.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums.
The drag reduction system.
Nice move. Good job. Pitting this lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap. Tire condition is still looking good. Release, release. gap to the car behind is 2.5 seconds. Lewis is in the pits. The gap to the car ahead is 4.2 seconds. Verstappen is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 4.4 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are 3 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:32.0. You're losing around 0.7 a lap. Currently, the fastest lap is a 1:31.6. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Nice work. You did well today. I think the boss will be happy with that one.
So, another fantastic victory for Red Bull today. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently. It's clear to see that they've put in the work and they should be proud of the victory they secured here. So, let's review the driver's standings. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Anthony Davidson, who do you pick?
Sebastian Vettel would definitely be my first choice. He showed up a lot of the drivers out on the track today and didn't show any signs of slowing down.
It's time to check out the constructor's standings. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts.
How do you feel seeing your teammate up on the podium?
How are you and your rival getting along? So talk us through what happened between you and your rival today. Appreciate your time.